Good morning to all. Today I'm going to discuss about some pharmacogenomic concept. Not all patients respond to drug therapy in a uniform or beneficial fashion. But with the development of molecular genetics, now we begin to explore how and why genetic variations affects person's response to drugs. So pharmacogenomics, what are the clinical prospects? Pharmacogenomics in this concept, that is, the right drug is given to the right patient at right dose. Genetic approaches used to analyze rare and common ADR as well as variability in efficacy. So what is pharmacogenomics and pharmacogenetics? Both are the two emerging trends in medical science which influence the success of drug development and therapeutics. Pharmacogenomics, that means the study of how genes affects a person's response to drugs. This is a relatively new field. It combines the pharmacology and genomics to develop effective and safe medications. Pharmacogenomics and pharmacogenetics. Pharmacogenetics usually refers how variation in one single gene influences the response to a single drug. In pharmacogenomics, we studies how all of the genes or genomes can influence response to drugs. This figure represents the concept of pharmacogenomics and genetics. Pharmacogenomics, this examines many genomics including large biological pathway, whole genomes to identify variants that together determine variability in response to drug therapy. In case of pharmacogenetics, this mainly focused on large clinical effects of a single gene variants in small number of group of patients. Next we go to origin and development. The concept of pharmacogenetics was first put forward by American geneticist Arno Motulsky more than half century ago, at a time when it was already becoming clear that variation in drug response is actually due to the effects of genetic inheritance. Another scientist is the Vernier Calori at the University of Toronto. He studies mainly on the butyryl cholinesterase genetic variation and prolonged apnea after treatment with muscle relaxant succinylcholine. David Price Ivanius at Johns Hopkins University, he studies mainly on the genetic variations in N-acetylation of antituberculosis drug isoniazid. This is the figure, this represents the one study. Here this is the figure A, this represents the 135 subjects are included in studies and 7 unrelated families are selected. This includes 7 unrelated families. Atypical butyl cholinesterase had less ability to catalyze the hydrolysis of succinylcholine and was resistant to inhibition by compound dubaquin. And so is which inhibition of plasma butyl cholinesterases by dubaquin is plotted as dubaquin number. Those subjects would be at a greatly increased risk of prolonged paralysis after treatment with standard dose of succinylcholine. In figure 2, thus B represents the N-acetyltransferase 2 genetic variation. Plasma concentration of isoniazid in 267, that is 267 subjects are selected 6 hours after the administration of an identical oral dose. These are shown in figure B. The biomodel does frequency distribution. This results from the polymorphism in NAT2 gene. Both these examples are the classical examples. This explains the PK variations because of the inherent differences in drug metabolism. So this both drug shows the variations based on this drug metabolism. What are the main goals of pharmacogenomics? For understanding the polymorphism of drug metabolizing enzymes, important genes and variants to predict drug toxicity, safety, efficacy that can be identified and implemented in clinical practice. Other advantages of pharmacogenomics to predict a patient's response to drugs, how patients respond to drug therapy, and to develop customized prescriptions to minimize or eliminate adverse effects of drugs, to improve rational drug development, and is also helpful to improve the accuracy of determining appropriate dosage of drugs, to screen and monitor certain disease, to improve efficacy and patients' compliance. So nowadays, this genetic testing has dramatically reduced the number of persons suffering from side effects to drugs. In 2002, this identified a particular gene variant is HLA-B5701 as being the key factor in hypersensitivity to Abcavir. Cytochrome CYP2C9 and VKORC1, these are the gene variants influencing the response to warfarin, this anticoagulant drug. And there is an international warfarin pharmacogenetic consortium which is devoted to pooling genotype and phenotype data that is relevant to the anticoagulant warfarin. There are so many factors that affecting the drug response. First one is the genetic. Maybe genetic factor also influence the drug response. That is genotype. That means is an organism's full hereditary informations. Phenotype means is an organism's actual observed properties like morphology, development or behavior. Sometimes this gender is also affects the drug responses. That is, females have a higher percentage of body fat than males, which is mainly affects the volume of distribution of certain drugs. Renal clearance of unchanged drug is decreased in females due to the lower glomerular filtration rate. There are so many environmental factors also affects the drug response to patients, like diseased conditions. With these patients in another disease conditions or previous treatment and the environment, these are also another factors that affecting the drug response. This polymorphism is important term in this pharmacogenomics. That is, genetic polymorphism is a Greek word derived from this poly means multiple. Multiple forms as a polymorphism is termed used in genetics to describe the multiple forms of a single gene that exist in an individual or among a group of individuals. Polymorphism, we can simply say that, is a variation in DNA sequence that is common in population. There are two types of sequence variation: single nucleotide polymorphism, insertion or deletions. The single nucleotide polymorphism is most commonly seen. It is a variation in single nucleotide that occurs at a specific position in the genome where each variation is present to some appreciable degree with population. These are some variability that affecting the drug response. First factor is drug activation. Drug activation, that means many drugs that treat like cancer need to activation to work. Activation is word that means this tuning on. It's the process of tuning on patients called enzymes. In that category, this enzymes speed up to chemical reactions in the body. So this activates a drug so that it can do its job. Each person's inherent variations in enzymes. These variations affects how fast a drug changes into its active form. For example, some persons break down drugs slowly. This means standard dose of treatment may not work as well. Another factor is drug deactivation. Drug also needs deactivation to limit the drug's exposure to healthy tissues. Deactivation is the process of tuning off. Some individuals may have slower enzymes, so this results high levels of drugs may remain in their body for long time. That means they may have influence a person's reactions to drug. Besides pharmacogenomics, other factors may influence person's reactions to drugs, that is age, gender, cancer stage, some lifestyle habits, smoking, drinking, alcohol, other disease conditions, medications that's taken for other conditions. These are the some other factors that influence the patient's response to drug therapy. And the one is the enzymes roles. What are the enzymes involved in pharmacogenomics? Most famous drug metabolizing enzymes are cytochrome P450 family is involved in metabolism of several drugs. Polymorphism in these genes have been implicated in drug response variation affecting up to 25% of all drug therapies. CYP2C9, this plays a major role in metabolism of warfarin to inactivate hydroxylated forms 7-hydroxy warfarin. CYP2C9 is the second greatest contributor to the variation in warfarin dosage discovered. This explains the warfarin pharmacogenomics. This figure shows the representation of pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic factors. How this pharmacokinetic and pharmacovariation factors affects the warfarin dosage. So this PK variation, that is pharmacokinetic variation, CYP2C9 dependent. Pharmacodynamic variation is VKORC1 is dependent pharmacogenomics factors that influence the final dose of warfarin. Sir, there are so many variants in may still contribute to variability in warfarin action, that is CYP4F2, CYP2C18. There are so many factors. This contribution seems to be small or affects only a small number of individuals. And prospective trials are now ongoing in the US and Europe to examine the utility of genotyping to guide warfarin and other vitamin K antagonists. CYP2D6 in the human brain is important for behavior. This CYP2D6 transforms 5-methoxytryptamine to serotonin in the brain of suicide attempters. Several studies have indicated serotonergic hyperfunctions in suicidal behavior. This explains the genetic polymorphism of CYP2D6. So this genetic polymorphism of CYP2D6 results in 4 phenotypes with significant clinical implications, especially poor metabolizers and ultra-short metabolizers. This figure represents the graphical representation of drug levels achieved in predicted phenotypes of CYP2D6 from different alleles of CYP2D6. Poor metabolizers usually exhibit decreased metabolism of drugs and thus requires lower dosage to avoid toxic effects. Adverse effects are due to elevated drug plasma levels occurs more frequently in poor metabolizers in case where the drug clearance is dependent on CYP2D6. Poor metabolizers can experience diminished effects with drugs that need to be metabolized to active compound by CYP2D6. For example, like this codeine, which is a prodrug and need to be contribute to morphine in patients. Inadequate transformations in poor metabolizers leads to diminished pain relief or even tolerance or addictions. In case of ultra metabolizers, short metabolizers, who has more than 2 functional alleles due to gene duplications or multiplications. So in case of ultra metabolizers would require lower dosage of codeine than normal since transformation of codeine to morphine is enhanced. Ultra-short metabolized patients given drugs active per seconds may be resistant to such treatment and more time may be required to adjust the dosage before therapeutic efficacy is achieved. These are patient groups, same diagnosis and same prescriptions are given to a patient group, but their response are different. Some patients chose the